ScoMo's welding disaster. Let's have a look. Hello everyone, Florian Heiser here and welcome to another episode of Heiser Says. Grab your stein of coffee because we are 100% in election campaign mode if our Prime Minister is trying to weld something together. Now, there's something in this article I want to discuss, but before we do that, let's have a look at his brilliant welding attempt here. Now, I'm an architect, guys. I have welded. I've taught myself to weld by watching YouTube videos of all things. You know, a bit of stick welding with a little welder I bought for $20. I had to weld some metal together on a boat trailer that I was transporting on the back of a tow truck. But what he does here, just it. I mean, bloody hell, it's really stupid and dangerous. So don't do this at home.
On the tools once again.
This edge here?
Yeah, I gotta do it.
So he's sparking up while he's got his bloody mask on up. I guess. I mean, has he never? Probably hasn't ever welded something before. I guess a lot of people haven't done it. It's fun. Okay, if you haven't done it, guys, learn how to do it. Okay, melting metal to other pieces of metal. It's awesome. It really is. One thing I learned was when you're recording it on your iPhone, it'll damage your glass on your iPhone, the pits of the metal here. So ScoMo can't weld. I mean, I guess, you know, no one's surprised with that, but at least he's given it a try and getting his hands on the tools. But the thing I thought that was quite interesting here, and we'll have a look at this article, guys, and I'll take you to the bit that stands out. So a clip of Prime Minister Scott Morrison on the tools again has embarrassed tradies across Australia. Really? I don't think it has. Mr. Morrison was at SVEL, Specialised Welding and Engineering, on Friday to announce a $21.9 million Indigenous Leadership and Governance Package as part of a trip to the Northern Territory. How much do you think of that package is going to get pissed away by bureaucrats? That's not what I want to talk about, but how often does it? It doesn't actually go to the young people that want to get a trade or learn a job or build a career or start a business. There's a lot of people that want to keep the indigenous, let's just say, in a useful position to milk all of the resources out of it. How many bureaucrats will be out of a job? Just think about that. Some of these towns. I'd rather see it go, you know, handing it to the individuals would probably be more efficient. But anyway, it was during this visit he was captured by Channel 7 News having a crack at welding, but instead of keeping his protective helmet over his face while undertaking the dangerous activity, he pulled his mask up at the worst possible moment. He said on the tools again, yes. Sally McManus, okay, a trade union secretary who's only ever, I looked at her LinkedIn, it only appears she's ever worked for the unions. Okay, that's not even a real job. It's not creating a business, it's not doing anything, it's just a bureaucrat. A rent-seeking bureaucrat. Anyway, of the Australian Council of Trade Unions, shared a clip on Twitter where Mr. Morrison was roasted. Some even compared him to the former US President Donald Trump, who was captured staring at an eclipse without protective eyewear while standing on the White House balcony in 2017. It happens. Even TAFE welding courses with health insurance companies should show, every TAFE welding course should show this. Yeah, they should. But let's have a look here. Mr. Morrison was there to plug this. It's not the only criticism Mr. Morrison has copped this week, with a local NT reporter grilling him about the crime situation in Alice Springs and authorities saying residents are living in fear. Okay. What the hell does that have to do with the Prime Minister in Alice Springs? They've got a state Labor government. They've got a state police force. Or is the federal police managing Alice Springs? It doesn't look like it. I've looked on the web, tried to find stuff out there. Or do they want the feds to come in and manage their city? Or is he doing it just to get publicity? Here's the thing. I don't think people understand how politics works in this country. I think they got no bloody idea. I think you're going to get a whole bunch of people who are pissed off at the premiers and Dan Andrews and then take it out on the Prime Minister at a federal level. As much as people aren't fans of ScoMo, do you want bloody Albanese in? Because that's probably your two choices, guys. The PM has also been described as desperate, was accused of politicising national security after he claimed Labour leader Anthony Albanese was China's pick for Australia's top job. He was, and he is. They prefer Labour and Albanese. Of course they do. Isn't it the new Comintern, the new... when are they having their next international, you know, international communist convention? Why isn't all the Labour parties going to that? It's pretty similar. Anyway, guys, let's have a talk about this. I mean, okay, a middle-aged boomer can't weld. I'm not surprised. Hopefully you'd be on the tools at least a bit as a dad doing some repair work around the house. Or maybe, I don't know. I mean, I'm an architect, but I'm working in the construction industry. So I'm a little bit more cautious around these type of things than probably a lifetime bureaucrat and civil servant is. Maybe that's it. But as much as you laugh at ScoMo, and, you know, the fear is that you may get Albanese, I'd love us to get a minor party in the House of Reps so these bastards have to negotiate with some sensible, normal people. Too many of them have been at their World Economic Forum junkets, traveling around the world, hobnobbing with who's who, that they seem to have forgotten what normal life is and how much of a pain in the ass a lot of these bureaucrats and politicians are on day-to-day people who just want to get on with living their bloody normal, boring lives. And maybe, just maybe, it'd be nice if we weren't stung with tax after tax and burden after burden. What do you reckon? Anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts and opinions on that one down below. Thanks for watching. And if you're a fan of the channel, there's a few ways you can help out. You can comment, share, subscribe. All the YouTube stuff, the algorithm loves it. You can support us financially via joining us on YouTube or Patreon. You can sign up for Self Wealth or Stake. If you sign up for Self Wealth, we each get 5 free share trades. Sure, they only last a month, but it helps me with my pocket money investing. So thank you to everyone who does that. And they're the cheapest Australian broker. So although Stake, you can get $3 CHESS sponsored share trades. I haven't used them for that. I've only used them for their US shares, but that's something to consider if you're looking at getting into the market with small amounts and where the brokerage fees can add up. You can use our referral links at Amazon, eBay, Independent Reserve, or Aussie Broadband. Buy our merch from Heiser Says, and we've got pocket squares there. And thank you all for watching, guys. And I want to point you towards this video here. This is about voting using your preferences. Okay? You need to encourage everyone you know to use their preferences at this next federal election so we get some good minor parties in there to make these bastards work for it. Remember the cash ban? Remember when there were people giving good speeches, warning about the implications of it, and there was no one there to listen to? Use your preferences. Take care. I'll see you next time.